glory days of pinball were probably the 1960s, 70s, and into the 80s. That would be in the era of the bell bottoms, would be the Pinball Wizard movie, which was big for the pinball machine, the Pinball Wizard. Then as it progressed over the years, more and more, you had arcade games came in and pinball sort of fell to the wayside.
Curly Weimer is more than a guy that likes to play pinball. He is a wholesaler of new pinball machines. He buys and sells old ones, and he operates a repair shop that fixes them all. Despite growing up during pinball's heyday, he didn't play much as a kid.
I might have played one or two games here and there, but I was never what you would call an aficionado in pinball itself.
He caught the bug after buying his first machine at an auction 25 years ago.
I just kept going to auctions, buying another one, and all of a sudden I got 40 pinball machines, and I'm spending more time working on them than I am playing them.
While trying to find machines to buy, Curly says his research showed 70% of pinball machines made in the U.S. were shipped overseas. So he traveled to Argentina and Europe buying containers full of pinball machines and shipping them back to the U.S. A lot of these machines needed repair.
But once I started bringing pinball back in, I'm sitting here going, well, now I need parts. So the best way for me to do it and keep the price down and keep the price down on the pinball for the customer is become a parts distributor. So it worked out, and next thing you know, I'm a parts distributor and I've got a room full of parts.
After pinball machines largely disappeared from arcades in the mid-90s, it was individual collectors like Curly that took pinball underground and kept it alive. The pinball parties Curly hosted at his home are legendary.
Every April, we would have people come in and just come in, enjoy pinball. Everything was set up free. We supplied all the food.
Curly would open his home to the entire collector community, which was, it's very gracious of him to do that. He would open up all his machines for us to play. It was one of those, mark it on the calendar, Curly's party. You had to go.
First year was kind of, you know, maybe 50, 60 people, which was fine. It was enough for me. But then the next year, it doubled. And the next year, it doubled. And every year from then on, it kept doubling up.
The yearly growth of Curly's parties reflected a larger trend, a revival of pinball in America.
Yeah, I'd say pinball has made a huge comeback. As the baby boomers got older, they could afford what they were buying. They saw this stuff coming up on eBay. And they sort of remembered back in the day when they were playing them games in college.
They came to Curly for help finding their machine.
And when they give me the name of the game, I say, well, come on in the showroom and play some of the newer stuff. And it's sort of, they still want the game that they played in college, but they also want the newer stuff also.
The revival is also playing out at pinball shows and tournaments. Free Play Florida is a show recently held in Orlando.
We expect over 1,000 attendees this weekend throughout the three-day event. Every year it has grown. Pinball as a whole has really just taken off the last 3 to 4 years in the state of Florida. It's become very, very hot topic for collectors and new collectors coming into the hobby. It is fun, and people forgot how fun it was. And they come to these shows and gatherings, and they play again, and they're almost 16 again.
I would go to the bowling alley, and I'd play, dump a bunch of quarters into these machines and play them for hours. And now as an adult, it's a whole different perspective. It brings back the old memories from when you're a kid. It also is a machine that requires skill.
Curly's company provided some of the new machines at the Free Play Florida event, but it's the old machines there that he enjoys seeing.
I bought thousands of pinball machines and sold them all over the state of Florida. So it feels good because most of the machines I see, odds are I sold it to that individual that brought them in. So it's nice to see them and see that they still work after all these years.
With the increased interest in pinball, Curly says business is big for his little shop of games.
We have athletes, movie stars, they're our customers. I have about 4 or 5 vendors that'll buy a title now and then to change it up a little bit in their arcades. But mostly it's homeowners that come in and they want to buy their first machine And I tell him, I says, well, you can buy your first machine, but I'll see you in about 6 months for your next machine. Because pinball is really addictive. You know, once they buy one, they end up buying another one, they end up buying another one. All the pinball machines coming out today are based off of movie titles, more than anything else. Every so often you might get one on a TV series, such as Walking Dead. Walking Dead is a very popular TV series and it has a heck of a following.
Trade-ins and resales are also a large part of his business.
I took the machine in on trade, but we can't sell it until it's completely stripped down. Everything is clean, scrubbed, and then all put back together.
Being the owner of a pinball shop does have its rewards. Lots of time to play pinball.
Do I think I'm good? Sure. Yeah, I'm good. Do I think I'm great? No, not even. But my whole thing is to enjoy it and have fun.
Even while having fun, Curly Weimer has also had a huge impact on pinball in Florida.
People like Curly, who've introduced a lot of the enthusiasts to pinball.
He's been integral to helping keep pinball in the forefront. He's been a good friend, a good guy, and he's definitely a cornerstone of the Florida. Everyone knows Curly.
I love the game. And I love working on the games. I love my customers. You know, I love everything about it. Does it make money? Sure. If it didn't make money, I wouldn't be here. But it's not going to make me rich. But it makes me happy. So sometimes happy is better than rich.